Hi, I'm Alice Fearn.
And I'm Emma Hatton.
And we, alongside Rachel Tucker and Louise Dearman,
will be performing Defying Gravity live on stage here at the London Palladium.
Catch us on Wednesday, the 23rd of September at 7 p.m.
on Magic at the Musicals.
I can't really believe it's just happened, because when I sort of agreed to do this, I sort of didn't quite compute what was happening and what would be happening. But yeah, we've just come off the stage, having all four of us performed for the first time together, singing Defying Gravity. And I think the word that I would describe it as is emotional.
Yeah.
Because we haven't sang it, we're not playing it at the minute, and I'm the most recent one. It's still well over a year ago that I finished. And to get up there with all these girls that are the girls that did it before me, that you mark yourself on and you say, God, I hope I'm as good as them, and they teach you so much about that role, to look at them and look beside us. And we all just had so much fun as well. Yeah. It was quite nerve-wracking, it was quite emotional, but I think I've never felt more supported by three of the women up on that stage. It will go down as one of my favourite days ever.
Exactly, and I think we were discussing it as well, weren't we, that what's so beautiful about the role of Elphaba is that it can be played across the four of us. There's four vastly different personalities and vocal types and physiques. And I think that what's so great about that role is that we're just four strong women who do support each other in that situation. But that role is so varied, the people that have played it. And I think there's no sense of competition. It's just support.
Yeah.
And particularly at a time where we aren't performing very much at the moment, to have such a special moment that I think we all would have gone a little bit crazy over prior to this time was made even more special because of the circumstances.
I think there's a special bond when you play Elphaba with other people that play Elphaba,
100%.
Because you know how hard it is. Mm. Like, the truth be told, it's a really, really difficult part. You mentioned it before, it's like a lifestyle.
So
it's a lifestyle choice, and it changes how you live day to day while you're playing it. And I think, therefore, you get four of us up there who've played it. And I think we all respect that within each other.
It's like an unspoken rule that you all know what you've been through. And I think it changes how you progress when you step away from that role, how you carry yourself and how you conduct yourself in the industry, doesn't it?
Completely.
And how you support other people.
Yeah. Oh, I love you guys. The role of Elphaba means to me, it represents strength. It represents a belief that what you think is right, you must continue on and you must follow, no matter what hardships come your way. That's what I love so much about her strength and her determination.
Yeah, and I think, just following on from what Alice has said, I think for me personally, what I loved about playing the role was that I was able to channel some of those characteristics and those strengths and take them into my personal life. And I think I've always believed in the greater good and doing what you feel is right and going against the grain, even if you feel like, you know, it's gonna make you really unpopular. And being different is something to be celebrated. And it was a real kind of privilege to portray that and go on that journey with a lot of the fan base who felt so ostracized and isolated, to be able to show them that you could be individual and you could stand up for what you believed in, and that there was a strength in that.
We should all be a bit more like Elphaba.
Yeah, really.
Be more Elphaba.
Oh, I would say that work hard. That's the most important thing, I think, initially when you're starting out, is to work hard, be nice to people. I think that's one of the, I don't believe in hierarchies. I think that you are a team when you work in theatre. And I think it's about forming a bond with the whole team, the whole company, whether it be your wardrobe, your wigs, your lighting, your sound. You become like a family. And I think that if your work ethic is good, take the job seriously, but not yourself. You know, we're not saving lives, but we are making a difference to people's lives. So be prepared to work hard, but don't take yourself too seriously.
Yeah, I would say if you're coming into the business, and even if your dream is Elphaba, it's, I think working hard is vital, but it's also believing in yourself. I think make sure that you trust yourself a little bit more than maybe. There's no point in going through all this career with worries, with judgment. If you don't get a job, you get a no. You can't take that too personally because it's full of them, sadly, this business. And I've never, you know, let the no's get to me. They maybe get to me for 24 hours, you know. But you've got to just have that belief that one day the right path will come your way, and whatever, regardless of that, what that is, you know, you just have to believe in that and believe in yourself that your hard work and your determination will get you there.
Yeah, I think it's amazing. And I think that as former Wicked cast members, I think we sort of blazed the trail with that, didn't we? Because we had two female leads. And that was something that I was incredibly proud of, to be a part of that. I think for young women to go to the theatre and see that there was a show that could represent them. And that was something that I felt incredibly proud to be a part of. So like you say, now to see that there is a musical that has now given, you know, the helm to six people equally, it's so wonderful to see, and it's so current, and it's got so much educational underpinning it that it's just brilliant. And the music's so catchy. I mean, I'm far too old to be in it, but it is brilliant.
Yeah, I mean, six, I think we could definitely blaze a trail there with female leads. But I also think it's blazing even further than that. And I think it's amazing that they've got six equal leads. I think it's amazing that they are diverse in that show. I think they constantly push the boundaries and say, yeah, we'll do that. You know, they're even the ones that are sort of opening first. I know that's probably helpful with the show and how it can be done. But they're even, you know, that's just, it's constantly, they're going, we'll do that, we'll be that, we'll, you know, and I think it's just extraordinary. And I'm for any show, any producer, any group of people that will constantly try to push those limits of what is allowed or what is done. And I think six do it. I've actually already bought my tickets because it came on sale yesterday for on pre-sale. And I've already bought my tickets to go and see it in December because I ain't missing that.